entire Republican caucus out there.
Yeah.
Well, that's why there was nowhere to park.
Yeah.
Yeah.
My real question is, I don't remember who is it. The tall representative who always wears the sneakers.
Sorry?
The tall representative who always wears the sneakers. He's blind. They're either...
Johnson. I don't know which would be worse.
I know. That's what I'm saying.
Thank you. about every station in the state is here, comma, I think, period. What?
That's not true. Is that true?
True, yeah.
Wow.
Come on in, everybody. Well, good morning. As of yesterday, this became the worst kept secret in Raleigh, I think. I want to welcome everyone here today with us. We have a number of our colleagues, of course, here standing with us, as well as a lot of colleagues here in the back. I'm very proud to be here today to join my colleagues and my newest Republican colleague, who will be making her official announcement shortly, to our caucus. I've had the pleasure of serving with Representative Cotham since she was first elected in 2006. I've been here since 2002. I've served in the minority, and I've served in the majority. Let me tell you, the majority's better. And I will tell you that even when I was in the minority and Representative Cotham was in the majority, She was always one of the most bipartisan members who would work with us a great deal. Dan probably can speak to that when he comes up as well. But it was amazing to me that in the last few weeks, the conversations that I had with Representative Cotham, it did seem that she, like so many, were seeing that perhaps she didn't have as much of a home in her former party as she did. One of the things that we pride ourselves on as Republicans is that we always tell our caucus members, vote your conscience, vote your district, and then vote with your caucus. That's a hallmark we have. And you can see that regularly. We had a vote, 3 weeks ago on the Medicaid bill where our caucus was, split. But you know what? We had our vote, everybody had their piece, and we moved on. Nobody attacked each other in the media. Nobody went after each other. We understand that having a big tent with ideas across the spectrum is what makes not just a party healthy, but it's what makes governing effective. Because North Carolina is that way. And the new modern face of the Republican Party is one that represents the values and the views of most of North Carolina. So in the last few weeks, as I was talking with Representative Cotham, I got a sense that she was unhappy, felt like she maybe was having to vote against her conscience in a lot of ways. And so told her that we'd love to have you. And by the way, she's not the only Democrat that we've had great conversations with. And because I think a lot of folks, you just see it's a national move where folks realize that that there's this wokeness, whatever you want to call it, has pervaded in a lot of ways. And there are a lot of folks on the other side of the aisle, I think, who are frustrated within their own party. But knowing Representative Cotham, knowing her commitment to Mecklenburg County and to North Carolina, she put policy over politics. She's been very principled. And so when she expressed an interest in talking with us, of course, I said yes. And we are honored today to have with us our newest member of the Republican caucus, Representative Tricia Cotham. Tricia, thank you.
Good morning, and thank you for being here. I am Tricia Cotham. I am a single mom of two amazing sons, a teacher, a small business owner, a woman with strong faith, a national championship basketball coach, and a public servant. Today, I add Republican to that list. Decided to change my party affiliation, joining the Republican Party, and have been welcomed with open arms by my colleagues, and I'm glad to call you all my colleagues. As long as I have been a Democrat, the Democrats have tried to be a big tent, but this now where we are, modern day Democratic Party, has become unrecognizable to me and to so many others throughout this state and this country. The party wants to villainize anyone who has free thought, free judgment, has solutions,